hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. As you log on tonight, log in shouting hallelujah. Come on, let's flood the atmosphere with the goodness of God, with his glory and with his presence. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Well, you know what to do. Continue to help us transform this world and manifest the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, by sharing this live stream with everyone you know and everyone that you love. Hallelujah. Let them know that the carriers of the kingdom are on live, and there is a word for you. Hallelujah. Somebody say, there is a word for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. As you log in, come on, log in, giving him glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We're carriers of the kingdom. And so we carry his glory. We carry his presence. Hallelujah. Here with us. Come on, let's expect an increase of the presence of the Lord on tonight. Somebody say, Lord, I expect increase. I expect an increase of your presence tonight, oh God. Flowing freely, uninterrupted, unhindered, unstopped. Hallelujah. Somebody say, he can't be stopped. Hallelujah. By any satanic or demonic force. Hallelujah. Come on and say that. I can't be stopped. I can't quit. Hallelujah. God, you've poured your spirit on the inside of us, Father. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Fall fresh. Overtake us on tonight, Lord. Influence every word that we speak, Father, in the name of Jesus, God. We thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you have anointed us. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Say that with me tonight. Yes, I'm speaking to you. You are anointed. God has entrusted you with his Son, with his Spirit living on the inside of you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We're carriers of your kingdom. Hallelujah. Somebody say, the kingdom lives on the inside of me. And because of that, I have everything that I need. As a matter of fact, I have more than I need. Come on. This is our time of declaration and praise. Hallelujah. We're coming to the Lord confident, bold, assured that we know who we are and we know whose we are. Come on. Somebody say, I carry his glory. I carry his glory, so I can't be hidden. Hallelujah. I carry the glory of the Lord. Therefore, when I step into the room, he enters the room. When you see me, you see the glory. Somebody shout, here comes the glory. Hallelujah. When you see me, you see the Father. When you hear me, you hear the Father. The words that I speak causes the enemy to flee. Hallelujah. Because I'm his representative. I'm his ambassador. I speak on his behalf. Hallelujah. I lay hands on the sick and they recover. Hallelujah. I heal on his behalf. Healing is manifested through my hands because I lay them for the Father. I represent him here on this earth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I carry the glory. I carry his glory. Somebody shout, here comes the glory. When you see me, the glory shows up. When you see me, things change. When you see me, the atmosphere has to change. Hallelujah. Sickness has to bow. Cancer has to bow. Lack has to bow. Insufficiency has to bow. Doubt and unbelief has to bow. Worthlessness has to bow. In the name of Jesus, hurt, pain, and disappointment has to bow. In the name of Jesus, here comes the glory. Here comes the glory. Hallelujah. I'm a carrier of his glory. I'm a carrier of his peace. My peace is undisturbed. Hallelujah. I have well-being, undisturbed well-being in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I walk in perfect peace. Why? Because Jesus, my mind is stayed on you. I set my affections. I've set my mind on you, Lord, and I'm keeping it set. I'm not coming down off of it. I'm not letting it go. Hallelujah. No matter how it feels, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it seems like, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, my mind is set on you. I have your purpose. I hold your intent, your attitude, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, Lord. I thank you, God. Hallelujah, that I'm a carrier of your love, Father, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. I thank you that I express your love. I thank you that all those I come into contact with, God, they express experience your love. God, you are love. Hallelujah. And because we're made in your image. Somebody say, I'm made in your image and in your likeness. Therefore, you, when you see me, you see love. When you come into the room with me and into my presence, you experience the love of Christ. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm a carrier of your anointing, Father. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I've been anointed to do what I do. I've been anointed to do this. I've been anointed to prophesy. I've been anointed to speak on your behalf. I am the prophetic voice that you call. Hallelujah. I've been anointed, command, and summoned to represent you in everything that I say, in everything that I do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I've been anointed to reveal you, Jesus, into the world. Somebody say, I'm revealing Jesus. I've received Jesus, and I'm revealing Jesus. I've received Jesus, and I'm revealing Jesus. I'm anointed to do this. This that I do, I don't do on my own. Hallelujah. The Father inside of me. Somebody say, he's on the inside of me, and he does the work. He's on the inside of me, and he does the work. The Father lives on the inside of me. He dwells there. He stays there. He abides there, and he does the work. Not in my own strength. I'm not doing this out of my own strength. Hallelujah. But I'm doing it to the one who's strong. I'm doing it to the one who's already won. I'm doing it to the one who's already conquered the grave. I'm doing it through the one who rose up with all power. Hallelujah. In his hands. And I thank you, Lord, that you've given me this power. You've entrusted me with this power. I'm a carrier of your power, God. I'm a carrier of your power, Lord. Come on, say that tonight. I'm a carrier of your power, God. I have the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Nothing can hurt me. Nothing can come up against me. Though 1,000 may fall at my side. Come on, say that tonight. Though 1,000 may fall at my side. 10,000 at my right hand. Nothing shall come near me. Nothing shall hurt me. No plague shall come near my dwelling. Nothing shall hurt my family. My children are protected. My home is protected. Everything that I possess is protected and shielded right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody say, I'm covered in the blood. I'm covered in the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus holds back the hand of the enemy. Hallelujah. We thank you, God. We give you glory for the power, God. You said you've given us power. Hallelujah. You've given us power. We walk in that power tonight, oh God. Somebody say, I'm walking in his power. I'm walking in his power. I'm bold. I'm strong. I'm confident. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Come on tonight. This is not based on how you feel. Hallelujah. But this is based on what we find in his word. His word says that you are strong. Hallelujah. When you are weak, it's him that makes you strong. Somebody say, I feel my strength coming on. I feel my strength coming on in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. No enemy can defeat me. Hallelujah. No foe can defeat me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We're carriers of your strength, Father. So in us, there is no weakness. Hallelujah. In us, there is no fear, Father. We're strong through you. We're mighty through you. We pull down every stronghold and every setback that tries to attach itself to our lives, Father. In the name of Jesus. And we're flowing in grace. We're flowing in your anointing. We're flowing in your love. We're flowing in your power. The glory is seen on our lives. Hallelujah. We can't be hidden. We can't be shut down. Come on. Here comes the glory. Here comes the glory. Here comes the glory. Hallelujah. Glorious healing. Hallelujah. We're carriers of your healing. Hallelujah. Come on. Lift up your hands despite how you feel. Say, Lord, I'm healed. I'm already healed. Hallelujah. We thank you that every negative report is being changed right now in the name of Jesus where your healing is concerned. We thank you that there's no more arthritis, no more diabetes, Father. In the name of Jesus. Oh my God. Thank you for your healing, God. Thank you that you've entrusted us to carry your healing, God. We thank you that every stripe that you've taken, God, for us, God, so that we can walk in healing consistently, constantly, Father. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We receive it. We walk in it today, God. We love your abundance, God. Hallelujah. We thank you that we've been abundantly supplied. There's nothing missing, nothing lacking, nothing broken in our lives. We have what we need in abundance, to the full, and to the overflow. Somebody say, here comes the overflow. In abundance, to the full, until it overflows. Come on. Lift up your hands where you are and say, I live under an open heaven, and so there's nothing that he withholds from me. He gave us Jesus. Come on. If he gave us Jesus, there's nothing that he will withhold from us. Hallelujah. We walk in abundance, to the full, until it overflows. Carriers of overflow. Carriers of abundance. Carriers of the fullness of God. Fully loaded with the love of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Here comes
Hallelujah.
The glory.
Here comes the glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Make some noise for Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Come on and give him the highest praise on tonight. Hallelujah. Father, we are so grateful in the name of Jesus to be in your presence.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the gathering of the champions.
Thank you, Lord.
We are so honored to have your presence here. Thank you that
thank
we're flowing under an open heaven, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are speaking freely through our vocal cords, thinking through our minds, Father. We are submitted
to you,
Father.
Yes,
Lord. Cause your words to flow
freely
out of our belly as rivers of living water.
Lord.
Flow with power, authority, clarity,
yes, God.
Understanding, revelation,
yes, God.
Knowledge, Father. Rain down your
Jesus.
Fire upon us, Father, and cause your words to pierce the hearts and minds
of every listener
on tonight. Lord, we thank you that this word is going across the world in the name of Jesus,
yes,
transforming the world and manifesting
yes,
your
God.
Kingdom
changing
here on the
lives,
earth.
Lord.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Come on and give God praise. Give God praise. Let us know you're here on tonight.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome to the Kingdom of Heaven Church International, Carriers of the Kingdom Bible Study. We are so grateful for you to be here with us on tonight. We ask that you just join in and participate in the service and just comment and like and share and all those good things help us as we continue to push this word to establish the kingdom here on the earth and expand the kingdom of heaven across the globe in the name of Jesus, making a mark in the lives of every hearer that will never be erased. Come on, give God praise on tonight.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
It's time that we know who we are and whose we are. And we're confident in that.
Yes.
We speak about every other thing that we support here on this earth. It's time for us to let the world know undoubtedly who we belong to.
Amen.
Who we're working for. Whose side that we're working on.
You with.
Hallelujah. Who you with. Hallelujah. It's time for us to unashamed, hallelujah, express the glory and the power of God here on this earth.
Amen.
We've got to know and we've got to understand that God is working on our behalf no matter what. No matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, no matter what's going on the TV, in the news, God has the final say. Somebody say that with me tonight.
Yes.
God has the final say. And no matter what it looks like. Some of you better open up your mouth and defy the natural tonight.
Natural
circumstances. No matter what it looks like. No matter what it seems like. No matter how I feel. I know.
Yes.
That I know. And I believe that God is working it out. He's working on my behalf.
Give you glory.
No matter
Thank you, Jesus.
God has the final say.
Thank you, Jesus.
Listen, the last time that we were here together, we stressed the importance of hearing the voice of God.
Yeah.
Speaking to you, flowing consistently and constantly with his instructions. We're in a time that you have got to hear the instructions of the Lord. You have got to know the strategies that God is unleashing for the believers. You've got to have a spiritual eye and a spiritual ear to hear what the Lord is speaking to you.
Yes.
Come on, we are his sheep.
Yes, we
know his voice.
Yes.
We are expected not to follow strangers. Hallelujah. It's time for us to stop following strange voices and to begin to rely on and to depend on God. We said it's time to hear and flow, hallelujah, to be led and guided by God's voice. And what that means is you're going to have to reject the voice and the lies of the enemy. Somebody shout deception.
Deception.
That yes, there's an increase of deception that has been unleashed. It's not what it looks like. There's a way that seems right
to a man.
Unto man, but the end is death. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. But God has a path for the believer.
Yes, he does.
Hallelujah. He has an expected end. Hallelujah. Uh-huh. If we'll continue to meditate on his word and to depend on his way. Hallelujah. He has a way that's been set up. Somebody say it's a setup.
It's a setup.
God is setting us up. He's been setting us up the whole time.
Yeah.
It's a setup.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
You're talking good talk tonight. Boy.
Listen. The Bible says that there, that he says in Matthew that there's going to come a time that there is going to shall arise a false Christ, false prophets, and shall show great signs. It says great signs and wonders, and they shall declare it shall deceive the very elect, the very chosen of God will be deceived. And there's another translation that says, and we're going on into this. Yeah. Somebody say, they're already, God, the Holy Spirit is already flowing.
Already flowing.
He says, don't fall for it. There's going to be fake messiahs. Mm-hmm. It even says, it calls them lying preachers.
Wow.
That are going to pop up everywhere. They're going to be come with impressive credentials, an impressive resume. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Bewitching performances, live on stage, theatrical productions. Hallelujah. Uh-huh. Religious acts. And they're going to pull the wool over the very eyes of God's chosen one, the elect, or those who ought to know better. Some of you ought to know better. It's time to know better. But God says that he's given us a fair warning.
Yes, he has.
God has given us warning after warning after warning. And you should be sensing an intensity in the spirit of the kingdom of God. And the kingdom of God is forcefully advancing. We've been telling you this. And just as the kingdom of God is forcefully advancing, so is the kingdom of darkness trying to attempt to do the same thing, to mimic the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
And if you're not careful and you don't know and recognize his voice, then you're going to be bewitched and bamboozled. Somebody say, oh, glory. No, not me.
Glory.
And so in this, God is saying, you got to trust in me. You got to build your hope in him. This is when you spend time with him. When you're spending time in the word, you're spending time with God, because he and his word are one. He's saying it's time to strengthen your faith and your confidence in him and in him alone. You can't be reaching after other gods and pursuing other gods, but to rely on him. Whose report are you going to believe?
Wow.
Who are you? We talked about this the last time. Who are you really going to listen to when it seems like there's no other way, or when it looks like God is a lie? Are you going to continue to hold on to what he's saying? We told you that the voice that you bend your ear to will be the one that will be the ruling and the guiding authority in your life.
Yeah.
You can't afford to listen to wrong voices.
Amen.
We know his sheep. We're his sheep. We know his voice. Uh-huh. And it's time for us to listen to him.
Uh-huh.
God's sheep intentionally avoid or reject that way that seems right,
amen,
that appears right, or gives a false impression of what should be right.
Mm. Wow.
Come on in here, Pastor.
Wow. Wow. You said so much. I'm trying to figure out where to start.
Come on.
I mean, it's so much.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Like you said, deception that's going on, and it's so amazing how God knows what messages to deliver to his people.
Yes.
in times.
Thank you, Lord.
We've been focusing on the hearing from God and discerning the voice of God, and because it's the highest form of hearing from God. And you said the sheep know the voice of the Lord. Amen. And because we are his sheep, we are supposed to know. So when these false prophets and preachers come with these dynamic services and theatrical productions, we know by way of discernment whether it's the spirit of the Lord moving or the spirit of deception. And it's so powerful because just listening to everything that you were saying, and you're talking about the Holy Spirit, you know, working behind the scenes. It's amazing how the Holy Spirit speaks. And when the Holy Spirit speaks, here's the key thing that I gather from everything that you said. when the Holy Spirit speaks, he's speaking in agreement with God. So that says that the Spirit, the Holy Spirit that's in your heart, will never contradict the Word.
Never.
The Word of God. See, the Word is Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is a Spirit, and they work together simultaneously. They're in unison, and they never contradict each other. And so when you use the voice from within, you're listening to the Holy Spirit who dwells on the inside of you. Amen. And so as you hear the Holy Spirit in transformation, we talked about transformation. Transformation is taking place, that says to me, this is the revelation. You reached down in this word and grabbed you a word and you studied it, like you said. You meditated on it, and to the point where you tied yourself to it, even in your physical senses, and it came alive on the inside of you. That's transformation.
Come on.
Because the word came alive on the inside of you, then there's a radical life change that took place in your life. What did that look like? It looks like this. The old way of thinking, it's gone. Why? It's stripped off of you. The word purges the old way of thinking to give birth to the new. And when you give birth to the new, like you said, we become the revealing reflection image of Jesus Christ that we present to the world. Well, that's powerful, because everything that you said is when you talked about the deceit. Kingdom citizens that have been in our services, you should not be the one that's deceived. You should be a step ahead of what's going on. Because the scripture says that nothing shall by any means take us unawares. Why? Because the Spirit is always speaking.
Always.
Amen.
Always.
Why is he speaking? So that he can demonstrate the truth that we receive from the Word of God, and we can demonstrate the power of God in our lives. Come on back in here.
Listen, we talked about how Paul heard God and he accepted what God said.
Yes, he did.
He began to work out. Paul was a murderer. He was killing the Christians. But once he had an experience with God and heard his voice, he began to work out for the kingdom of God, to carry out kingdom business. Samuel, we talked about he became to make way for Jesus. Samuel heard God. And after he heard God and he accepted, hallelujah, what God has said to him, hallelujah, none of his words fell to the ground. They both heard, and they both demonstrated that God was working behind the scenes. Hallelujah. God was active in their situations, even when it didn't look like it. Paul was a murderer.
He was a murderer.
Samuel was being taught by Eli, and he was saying, I don't know, I've heard something, I'm hearing a voice, I don't know who it is. Even when it didn't look like it, hallelujah, God was still working behind the scenes. But it was when they accepted it, hallelujah, and positioned themselves to hear his voice, hallelujah, when God was able to manifest himself, what was in the unseen became seen. Hallelujah. Somebody say transformation.
Transformation.
And then it was being experienced by all. Just like we told you, we've been telling you throughout this pandemic, God has been giving us instructions and God has been giving us strategy concerning this pandemic. We've told you we're shifting, and we're shifting again. And when he moves, you move just like that and flow with the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Make sure that you're hearing. Make sure that you are increasing your knowledge in him. Being able to be conditioned for what's to come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Continuing to train to reign. Hallelujah. Continuing to make sure that you are armed for the mission.
Yes.
All the messages that we preach, we told you don't believe what you're seeing on TV, but to begin to rely on what God is saying, and allow God to speak to you through what's being seen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And so now we see confirmation that God was working behind the scenes.
Yes,
that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. Everything that he spoke to us and everything that he showed us concerning this pandemic, hallelujah, God has shifted us. He has shielded us. He's protected us. He continued to set us aside. He continues to show us the way, light up every pathway. He continued to give us a word. He continued to tell us what to do, even before anything ever happened, hallelujah. So what you are seeing right now, hallelujah, should not be anything that's not normal. It should not be anything that's taking you by surprise. You should be saying, there it is, hallelujah. The glory has shown up. God has manifested every word that he spoke to you. And glory be to God. that I did what he said, that I'm protected, hallelujah. I listened to what he said, hallelujah. So I'm not panicking. I'm not afraid, hallelujah. I did what he said. I heard his voice. He was working behind the scenes on my behalf, hallelujah. He's already worked it out, hallelujah. And so I'm sitting back calm and cool, hallelujah, because I was already prepared.
Glory to God.
Somebody shout, God is working behind the scenes.
God is showing up working behind
the scenes. Oh my God.
That's so powerful.
Lord, have mercy.
When you have a relationship with the Holy Spirit and you allow him to work, somebody say working. When you allow him to work it and speak to you and guide you into all truth, although you see what's going on in the natural on the television, you hear it on the radio, you see it on the billboards, you don't allow the spirit of fear to come in. Why? Because the Holy Spirit keeps you at a calm place, at that place of perfect peace on the inside in him. And he does that because he knows that if you allow the spirit of fear to come in, fear, hallelujah, brings in loss. Fear brings in sickness.
Yes.
Fear brings in poverty. That's what it does. It looses it in your world. Somebody say your world.
Your world.
So you can take every precaution there is. You can prepare as much as you want to. If you allow fear to invade your life, if it's not done in faith, hallelujah, the fear will manifest the sickness, the disease, the poverty, the lack in your life. So you have to go back and ask yourself, what have I been thinking? What have I been? Where have I been? Have I allowed the Spirit to speak? Because when the Spirit speaks, we've been talking about this on Sunday, everything that the Holy Spirit says is spiritually discerned.
Yes, yes.
And so if you are spending more time in the natural than in the spiritual, you better go back and check yourself, hallelujah, and get into the Spirit so that you can hear what the Lord is saying and strip yourself of the fear that has caused you to come under subjection to the world system.
Jesus. God is working behind the scenes.
Yes, he is.
God is working.
Yes, he is.
We told you we were in reloading phase, so you should already be prepared. We told you that it was not over when it looked like in the world that everything had come to an end. Hallelujah. God was speaking clearly. To the ones that he could trust, hallelujah. Yeah. To the remnant, to his chosen, hallelujah.
Yeah.
He was speaking, hallelujah. Mm-hmm. You've got to get to the place where you set your thoughts and you set your mind and your entire being on the fact that God is already active in my situation and you keep it set. God is protecting me.
Yes,
keep it set. God is leading and guiding me. Keep it set. God is shielding me. Keep it set. God has prepared the way for me and keep it set. Even making ways out of no way, ways in the wilderness. Come on, the Bible says he's providing rivers in desert places.
Yes, yes, yes.
You got to keep your mind set on that. You got to keep it set.
Mm-hmm.
We always quote Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the assurance of the things we don't see. The title deed. It's a title deed. The things that we hope for. The word of God is the proof.
Yes, he is.
If you want the proof, you've got to get in his word because the word is the proof. The word is the proof that we need to hold on to until those things that he's working behind the scenes come into pass and come into manifestation. You've got to hold on to the word as the proof until the proof comes forth and manifests. God goes before us. He sees beyond what we can see, our circumstances and our situation. God has seen beyond this coronavirus, but we've got to do our part. Hallelujah. Why am I talking about this? Because I know everybody's been glued to the TV this week. It's time for the children to go back to school. They're saying, we kept saying, take off the mask, put on the mask. It's time for you to put on Jesus, hallelujah. Be clothed with Jesus. Mm-hmm. Take on the divine nature of Christ, hallelujah, so that you can withstand the wiles of the enemy, the devil, the one that wants to destroy you.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, when I think about, oh Lord, when Moses was leading the children of Israel out of Egypt,
mm-hmm.
Pharaoh was rejecting what he was saying.
Yes.
He said, let my people go. God had given the final warning. Moses was, he instructed the people, okay, that he don't want to listen. Mm-hmm. So let me be the mouthpiece of God and tell you what to do. Come on, somebody, so y'all know this story.
Yeah, y'all do. Come on.
Hallelujah. So we're talking about applying the blood. Somebody say applying the blood. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Listen, but they had a part, the children had a, the elect, the one who has spiritual ears and eyes to hear and see and to trust, no matter what it looked like, hallelujah, they had to trust what the man of God was speaking to them. It's time for you to get under the tutelage of someone, just like Samuel and Eli, trust. That you can trust the words that are flowing out of their mouth. Yes. Somebody said, do you hear the words that are coming out of my mouth? Hallelujah. They had to apply the blood. Yes. Somebody shout, by faith.
By faith.
By faith.
By faith.
Applying the blood simply demonstrates the full assurance and the confidence in the word of God, the strategy, the instruction, and the wisdom that he has set forth for you. His protection that's been unleashed and unveiled for you. The secrets that he has provided for you. Mm. Applying the blood set them apart from the crowd. It shifted them and put them in the VIP section. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. The feathers of the Holy One was on around them. Hallelujah. They were dwelling in the secret place of the Most High when they applied the blood of God, because they trusted in him. Their confidence was in them. Mm. Applying the blood helped them to keep their mindset. It was a point of contact. It was something they could look at, to hold on to, that God, that reminded them that, God, I know you won't fail me. Yeah. I know you protect me. I know you won't leave me. I don't care what's going on out there in the streets, what's going on in the world, or going on in the TV. I've got the blood applied to my life. I've got the blood applied over my family, over my finances, over my dwelling. Hallelujah. It's time to apply the blood of Jesus over our lives and over every circumstance, over our families, our children. Your children are going back to school. Apply the blood. Hallelujah. It never loses its power. Hallelujah. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It will never, never lose its power.
The blood.
Why not apply it? Who wouldn't apply the blood of Jesus? Somebody shout, God is working behind the scenes.
He's working behind.
I dwell in the secret place of the Most High. He's working. He's working. He's working. It's working. Come on, Pastor. Oh, let's stay right here for a moment and talk about this, applying this word of Jesus, how he goes and works on our behalf behind the scenes when we apply the blood. Hallelujah. So
let's sit here. Can we sit here for a minute and talk about this?
Woo, you better come on, Pastor. Come on, please.
So when you're talking about the blood of Jesus and what it represents, y'all, this is what you have to understand. The blood of Jesus represents his presence.
Come on.
It represents him.
Yes.
Life is in the blood. So when the blood was smeared across the door, the destroyer knew God is with them.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They are in God.
Mm-hmm.
I can't touch them.
Mm-mm. The head is marked.
So you said that you apply the blood over your money, over your house.
Yeah.
You apply it over your life. You apply the blood over everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so what that says to me is God is active in my situation, in every circumstance, in every aspect of my life. That's what that says to me. And you can say that because when you look back at the Old Testament, when they were saying Jehovah Rapha, what was they saying? God is my healer. And so every area that the blood is applied to represents a dimension of God.
Come on, Pat.
See, we got to get to a level of understanding that God, hallelujah, is active in, and he flows through every dimension of our lives. See, he's not just a God that's just sitting on a throne, hallelujah. He is in you. We got to get to the point where we know that God is in us. And so when you start talking about faith is the substance, we know that the substance is the word of God. And we also know that the word of God is God based on the scripture. And so Your faith or your confidence, your absolute trust is in God. Your confidence is God is with you. You're the thing that you can bank on, that he lives on the inside of you. And so I said to you in the beginning that the Holy Spirit that dwells in your heart will never contradict the spirit that's in the word. Why? Because they are one.
They're one.
And so when you start talking about the blood, you were talking about our Lord and Savior Jesus, who is one with God. Hallelujah. Who is God. So because the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, was shed for me, covered me, hallelujah, I strip myself of myself and I take on him.
Jesus.
And so now you experience him when you see me. When you come into contact with me, you experience God. You see God revealing himself through me. Hallelujah. I'm talking to somebody out
on,
there who is walking in low self-esteem, who didn't have this type of mindset. I'm telling you, because you've accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you've stripped yourself of your old nature, hallelujah, and you've taken on, hallelujah, the spirit, the person of God, Jesus Christ, here on the earth, and he gave you his Holy Spirit to seal you so that you can be reassured and confident that the substance that he placed on the inside of you is full and alive, full of his power, and ready to reveal and manifest his glory through you. But you have to trust that he is working behind the scenes on your behalf, hallelujah. When you go to pray, you need to know, hallelujah.
Come on.
You're groaning, hallelujah. This the Holy Spirit making intercession to ensure that, hallelujah, your emotions don't try to override the will of God. You know, what happens sometimes, because sometimes you get emotional and you start functioning in what we call anxiety and stress, and you get overtaken by your emotions, and then you make decisions outside of the will of God. No, allow the Holy Spirit, God, who's working behind the scenes, guide you into all truth. So tonight I say, keep calm, hallelujah, and remember the blood, hallelujah, the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, who has been applied to your life, hallelujah, is with you, hallelujah. Glory to be to God, hallelujah. When you look at the scripture, he confirms himself to you to say to you that I'm with you, I'm in you, hallelujah. You've taken on my nature, you've taken on my person, you've taken on my character. Activate the power, I'm working behind
Activate
the scenes.
The power.
When you stretch forth your hand, it's me working behind the scenes to release my power,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Glory,
when you
Lord.
Speak in
Glory,
agreement
Lord.
With me, hallelujah, it's me working behind
Jesus,
the scenes, hallelujah,
Jesus.
To release my glory in your life, hallelujah. When you trusted in me, hallelujah, and you're testifying of me, hallelujah, it is God, me, hallelujah, working behind the scenes to bring it to pass in your life. Somebody give God praise.
Lord, have mercy.
I felt that.
Listen.
Ooh, I felt that.
Listen. In Romans 8:28, it says that we are assured and we know.
Yes.
That God, being a partner in our labor.
Yes, yes, yes.
Working behind the
partner.
Scenes. Somebody say working behind the scenes. That means they had a part to play.
A partnership, yeah.
Co-laboring.
Yes.
All things. We are assured and know that God, being a partner in their labor, all things work together and are fitting into a plan for good to and for those who love God and are called according to his design.
Yes.
And according to his purpose.
Mm-hmm.
And then 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, As what eye has not seen and ear has not heard and has not entered into the heart of man, all that God has prepared or made or keeps ready. Somebody say working behind the scenes
for those
who love him, who hold him in affectionate reverence, properly obeying him and gratefully recognizing the benefits he has bestowed. Listen, when I think about the making, let me just make this relevant. Thank you, Holy Spirit. When I think about the making of a blockbuster movie, because Jesus spoke in parables, he makes sure everybody understands. When I think about the making of a blockbuster movie. When you think about a blockbuster movie, it's a popular movie. Everybody wants to flock to go see this movie. The movie is financially successful. It brings in a lot of money. That's the intent. It gets big results, right? It's an extravagant. They go all out for this blockbuster.
Yeah.
The purpose of this movie from the beginning is to affect every life. All nationalities, all ages, or whatever the case may be, in some way, and they intend to get huge and lasting results. Amen. But how many of you know that there is a work that goes on behind the scene that makes this vision manifest?
Come on.
Somebody say manifest the vision.
Manifest the vision.
Now, in the making of this blockbuster, you always have to have a director. Now, this director is the main visionary. So he takes his visionary and brings it to life.
Yes.
Causes it to come to life. Hallelujah. What's on the inside of him comes to life for everyone to experience and to see. Listen, he guides the fulfillment of the vision that he has for this blockbuster. He directs, controls, and manages the vision of the motion picture.
So he writes the vision.
He writes the vision. Come on, some of y'all know where I'm going with this. Some of y'all should already know where I'm going. God is our director. God is the when we allow him to, God writes the story of our lives. He's our creative director. Somebody say, God is my creative director. Hallelujah. He's calling all of the shots. He takes the vision on the inside of him for my life, and he causes it to come to life, to come to manifestation. Somebody say, God is working behind the scenes.
He's working behind the scenes.
He directs and he manages and he controls. Controls the outcome of my life. He sees my life all the way through. The Bible says in Jeremiah 1 that he watches over his word or over his vision to make sure that it's performed and make sure that it manifests in my life. He knows the end from the beginning. Yeah. His focus for my life the entire time is success. Somebody say, God is working behind the scenes. God is concerned about your final outcome. Listen, let me prove it to you. In Jeremiah 29 and 11, he says, I know what I'm doing. I know I know this. I got this. I know the plans that I have for your life. He says, I've got it all planned out. I know what I'm doing. He says, I have plans to take care of you, not to abandon you. Plans to give you a future, to give you a future to hope for. Plans of good, no plans of evil, no plans of disaster. He says that the plans of your life will be peaceful, undisturbed well-being. There'll be no evil. Then he turns around in Joshua 1 and 8 and says, the book of the law should not depart out of your mouth, hallelujah, but you shall meditate on it day and night. When you're meditating on it day and night, you're meditating on this vision, hallelujah. Then you begin to see this vision. Then you begin to write the vision. The vision continues to be more plain for you, hallelujah. He says so that you can observe to do all that's in it. Then you will make your way prosperous. Somebody say, I'm doing the work. I'm helping him. I'm co-laboring with Christ while he's working behind the scenes. I'm doing the work. My way is then being made prosperous, and now I'm dealing wisely in the world. Now I'm dealing wisely concerning coronavirus. Now I'm dealing wisely and I'm not afraid of an economic downfall. Now I'm dealing wisely and I'm not afraid when my children have to go to school because they're not vaccinated. Now I'm dealing wisely and I'm having good success in every area of my life. Why? Because when I spend time in his word, I'm spending time with him. Because according to the Bible, he and his word are one. John 1 and 1. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Hallelujah.
Oh my God.
He's saying to you, this is what's going to cause you to be strong. Spending time with me, spending time with my word. You can't do this without the word of God. If you've been trying to do this without the word of God, that's why you're tired. That's why you're worn down and you're worn out. But enough is enough today. You're going to begin to spend time with the word of God. Then your strength is coming. You're continuing to be strong and courageous. He told you to be bold, be vigorous while he's working it all out. Somebody shout, he's working behind the scenes. You're becoming more patient. He said, continue to speak his language. Say what he he says, don't agree with the world. Hallelujah. There's no reason to be afraid. He says there's no reason to be dismayed. There's no reason to panic, for he is the Lord our God, and he is with us, and he's working, hallelujah, in and through you, hallelujah. Wherever you go, somebody shout, God is working behind the scenes.
God is working behind the scenes, but
Pastor, this is supposed to be Bible study.
It is Bible study. This is Bible. This is the Holy Spirit.
That's what
Bible
somebody's study. Saying.
This is the Holy Spirit's Bible.
God study. Is so good.
But can we go back to Romans 8? And I want to look at 27 because we need to know this. Not all scenes make it to the big show.
Oh God.
They don't.
They don't make the final cut.
Can we be real? They don't.
Come on, Pastor.
So we know that we have the Holy Spirit on the inside of
us.
And we know that he will never contradict his word.
Never.
So I'm going to read verse 27, Romans 8. It says this, and I'm going to read it here in the Amplified. It says, he who searches the hearts of men know what is in the mind of the Holy Spirit and what his intent is. Because the Spirit intercedes and pleads before God in behalf of the saints according to and in harmony with God's will. With God's will. Let me say that. So sometimes our emotional state tries to move faster than the Spirit of God. And we know that Hebrews 4:12 says that the word of God is quick or alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, right? Piercing and dividing asunder soul and spirit down to the very joint and marrow. So this says here that he is searching to see what his intent is. And so the word knows the thoughts and intents of the heart of a man. And sometimes your desires contradict the will of God. And when your desires contradict the will of God, because the Holy Spirit is making intercession for you,
yes,
and he's working behind the scenes, sometimes some parts of the movie don't make the final cut. Sometimes I'm answering this question because I hear somebody saying, I prayed a prayer and I didn't get an answer. No, the Holy Spirit was making intercession.
Yes.
And the answer you thought you got was something that came out of your emotional state. And you did not discern that the Holy Spirit was trying to implant in your soul the desire or the will and intent of God. That's why the scripture says he gives you the desires of your heart. He gives you the desire because he knows the plan that he has for you, the thoughts of good and not evil to give you expected end. And so sometimes, because of this has been a lifelong question going on, and they said, I prayed and I didn't get an answer. No, you got an answer, but it wasn't the answer that you expected, because you have to understand the Holy Spirit working behind the scenes,
Lord,
was protecting you because he's a keeper. He was keeping you because
Lord,
he's a counselor. He was counseling you because he is the guiding ruler in the earth for the believer. Hallelujah. He was guiding you into the truth that God had for you. Hallelujah. And so now you have a clear understanding of what he was saying. And then because when you prayed a prayer and you did not spiritually discern what the Spirit was saying, he had to override your will so that the will of God could be done in your life.
Listen,
was that too much?
Listen, Christina said on here, thank you for the deleted scenes, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you for the deleted scenes. Thank you for those bloopers and those blunders.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That are always cut out.
Yes.
That would have tripped us up and caused us to go into another direction. Mm-hmm. Thank you for covering us. Thank you that those parts of our lives were not seen. He covered us. Mm-hmm. How many of you, God covered all your mistakes and wrong decisions? He was working behind the scenes and he kept you. Listen, when people see you, they see the Father.
Yeah.
Because I've told you, you're covered by the blood of Jesus. You've now been covered by the blood. Mm-hmm. So they don't see those mistakes. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
They don't see those deleted scenes. They don't see when he shielded you and he kept you apart and he kept you protected, hallelujah, from the world, hallelujah, what people would say and how they would judge you. Somebody shout, thank you, Lord, for the deleted scenes.
And some of y'all got snatched out of some situations.
Didn't make the final cut.
It didn't make the final cut.
His manuscript.
And you tried to force your way force your way out of your own strength because you were led by Lord your emotional, mercy. Physical self. And so because you went on in it, hallelujah, he had to snatch you out of the situation to save you and to manifest his glory in your life.
Listen.
Somebody say the Holy Spirit is working behind the scenes.
Holy Spirit is working behind the scenes.
He's working.
He even goes before you.
Yes, he does.
One of the scriptures when it talks about he goes before you is in Isaiah 45:2. He says, and we're going to go through this real quickly. You can go back and read it in your leisure, in your study time. He says, I will go before you and level the mountains to make the crooked places straight. Some of our crooked places have been made straight. Why? Because God was working behind the scenes.
Yeah.
He said, I will break in the pieces, the doors of bronze, and cut asunder the bars of iron. Mm-hmm. And I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, working behind the scenes, that you may know that it is the Lord, that it is I, the Lord, the God of Israel, who calls you by your name. What is he saying? He said, I'll go ahead of you. I'll clear and pave the road. He's going to break down those things that try to hold you, try to deter you, try to hold you up and slow you down. He said he's kicking down those entrances. Doors being open for you that were closed. He's going behind, before you and working behind the scenes. He says he'll lead you to those secret riches, those hidden treasures. He says confirmations that it is in fact he's giving you. God is giving you confirmation. Come on, somebody receive that tonight. God is confirming to you
tonight.
That in fact he is God. Hallelujah.
Yes,
he calls you by name. That he's wrote your story. Mm-hmm. He's your creative director. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, he's written every scene in your life and he's deleted some scenes in your life. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, Lord.
Jesus.
Oh my God.
Man, the Spirit is speaking on tonight. There's some of you trying to figure out, is God speaking to me? Yes, he's speaking to you.
Yes, he's going before you.
It's time for you to focus. Somebody say focus. It's time for you to shut down the outside forces, the TV people. It's time for you to get tuned into God and allow him to speak, because he's speaking to you in your heart. He's there to guide you into all truth, because he wants God's intention. Jesus came that we might have and enjoy life. And the Holy Spirit is keeping you because the enemy is trying to kill you. He's trying to steal what God has prepared for you. He's trying to destroy you because he don't want the truth to be revealed to the world. And you are in position right now. I'm talking to somebody. You are in position to reveal the truth, reveal Jesus to your family members that have been lost and going astray. Some of you are in positions right now that God is going to manifest his glory. Doors that you didn't expect to be open for you are opening right now.
Right now, in
Jesus' mighty name, I'm declaring that over your life.
Yes.
And I'm declaring to you tonight that miracles, hallelujah, will begin to manifest on a greater level like we've never experienced before. All you got to do is focus and expect, hallelujah, and see and hear what God is saying and doing right now. I'm telling you.
Pastor, you said miracles are going to begin to happen on a greater level.
Yes.
You're
not
able
to, and twosies.
Again,
yes.
We're able to say that,
yes.
Because God is working behind the scenes.
Mm-hmm.
Because God is going before,
yes.
Before you.
Before you.
Another scripture is Deuteronomy 1:30. We want to give you some scripture before we leave you.
Mm-hmm.
It says, but I said to you, don't be shocked. And you need to go back and read these. Don't be, stand on these scriptures that God is going before you, working behind the scenes. Deuteronomy 1:30.
Mm-hmm.
But I said to you, don't be shocked or afraid of them. The Lord your God is going ahead of you. He will fight for you, just as you saw him do in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
And you saw how the Lord your God cared for you all along the way as you traveled through the wilderness.
God
is caring for you all along the way, although you may feel like it's wilderness, just as the Father cared. cares for his child. Now he has brought you to this place. Deuteronomy 31:8.
I got it right there. Yeah.
It is the Lord. Somebody say, it is the Lord.
It is the Lord.
Who goes before you.
Yeah.
He will march with you.
Mm-hmm.
He will not fail you
mm-hmm.
or let you go or forsake you. Let there be no cowardness, no flinching, but fear not.
Mm-hmm.
Neither become broken in spirit, neither become depressed, dismayed, and unnerved with alarm. And then he turns around in two scriptures and tells us not only is he going before us, but he goes behind us. Psalms 139:5. He says, you go before me and follow me.
Yes,
so he's got you covered. Somebody say, he's got me covered.
He got me covered.
You place your hand of blessing on my head. I look behind me and you're there. That's what he's saying.
Oh,
Lord, I look behind me, you're there. I look in front of me and you're there.
Mm.
I look up ahead and you're there too.
Mm.
Your reassuring presence is coming and going.
Mm.
Looking after me, making sure that your word is performed.
Yes.
Isaiah 52:12. He's going before you and behind you. It says, for you will not go out with haste, nor will you go and fight as was necessary when Israel left Egypt. For the Lord will go before you, and the God of Israel will be your rear guard. Hallelujah. You will not leave in a hurry. You're not going to be scared. You're not going to panic, running for your lives. For the Lord will go ahead of you. Yes, the God of Israel will protect you from behind. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Somebody say, God is working behind the scenes.
He's
going before me, and he's sealing the gap behind me. Hallelujah.
That's powerful.
Listen, if you go to 2 Corinthians, and unless you have something else, Pastor, in 2 Corinthians 4:18, and I thank God so much for those who are tapped in. I was scrolling through, I had a notification on my Facebook today, and one of my dear sisters, Melva, she had posted a meditation today, and it talks about looking to the things that are unseen.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, God, I thank you for confirmation of what you are saying that someone else is hearing. It says here that since we consider and look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen, for the things that are visible are temporal. The things that we see are brief. Hallelujah. But the things that are invisible that we don't see are deathless and everlasting. Somebody say, God is working behind the scenes to bring those things into our sight that we don't see. So what is he saying? So what can we say? We're not giving up.
Mm-hmm.
How could we give up?
Okay.
Even though on the outside things look crazy, it looks like things are falling apart. Somebody say, but in the kingdom of God,
in the kingdom of
protection, in the secret place of the Most High, in the place that you're sheltered in and being protected and covered and set aside, not a day goes by without God's grace.
Mm-hmm.
Not a day goes by without his unmerited favor over and over and over and over. The times that we're faced with right now cannot be compared to what God has for you. You and I, hallelujah. There's far more that God has for us than meets the eye, hallelujah.
Yes, it is.
Thank you, Lord. The things we can't see, hallelujah, they're going to last forever.
They're going to last
Look into the things that are unseen. We're not worrying about the troubles that we see now. We're fixing our gaze. We're setting our affection. We're fixing our eyes on the things that can't be seen. Now faith right now, present faith, are the substance. Faith is the proof and the substance of the things we hope for. It is the evidence of what we don't see. Get into the evidence. Hold on to the evidence.
Mm.
Study and become one with the evidence and manifest. Hallelujah.
Mm.
But not in your own strength. Philippians 2:13, not in your own strength. Come on, we gave you some scripture. We're not doing this. We're not saying this out of our own strength, but the strength of God who's all the while effectually working and energizing and creating in you, the creative director giving you the power and the desire both to will and to work his good pleasure and satisfaction in his delight. God is working behind the scenes.
He's working behind the scenes. And the Holy Spirit.
You got to know this, no matter what.
The Holy Spirit is ensuring that his will is executed.
Jesus.
And you know, you hit some key things on tonight. And you need to know this.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Since you have the Holy Spirit living on the inside of you, and he's working behind the scenes, That goes back to the transformation process. What are you thinking? What are you saying? And me and you were having a conversation, and I shared with you that you cannot allow negative thinking to fill your mind.
No.
Because if you allow negative thinking to fill your mind, it's going to tie itself to your feelings.
Mm-hmm.
And when it ties itself to your feelings, you have to experience the consequences of those thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Because you've given birth to it. But because the Holy Spirit is working behind the scenes, he's always, always, always impressing the word of God and the will of God in the hearts of the believers.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody got to let them work.
Yes.
And listen for the voice of God.
Yes.
Because he's working behind the scenes to bring his promises to pass in our lives.
Yes.
It's just that simple.
Listen, even if we can't open, if we get to a place where we may not be able to open up our mouths,
amen,
and say a word, just think on the things of,
yes,
God.
Yes, yes.
Just keep your thoughts and your mind stayed on him.
Things.
Somebody shout perfect peace.
Think on these
He keeps
things.
You in perfect
oh
peace.
God.
I've been focusing on the peace of God this week. Perfect peace. Undisturbed well-being. I refuse not to walk in his peace.
Come on.
Don't come off of it. Don't let go of it no matter what. Keep my mind set on the word and the will of God. Why? Because his word is quick and powerful. We need, just as the enemy is trying to advance itself quickly, we need to allow the word of God to move quickly,
mm-hmm,
to come out of our mouths quickly, to think on those things that are lovely and pure, of a good report, to unleash loveliness into this earth through us. Because the word of God is quick and powerful.
Amen.
Alive.
Yes, it is.
It makes the will of God and the word of God active. It energizes us. It makes us effective. It goes in and it cuts and it binds. And then it turns around and it looses. His intents is sharper than any two-edged sword.
It's the end game.
It exposes. It sifts. It analyzes. It judges. Hallelujah. The word of God. God is working behind the scenes. You can walk in. You can have perfect peace. You will walk in undisturbed well-being. You will have divine health and healing to 120. Some of us passed 120. You will have everything that you need in your finances. You will walk in financial overflow. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Relationships will be restored. Hallelujah. Hearts will be healed. Hallelujah. Bodies will be healed. Hallelujah. Divine wholeness. Hallelujah, will be manifested. Signs, wonders, and miracles shall follow the words that you preach. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Powerful. Thank you, Lord.
Man, this was good.
Thank you, Lord. God is working. He's working. Somebody shout, he's working. He's working.
He's working.
He's working, even though I can't see it. He's working. Faith is not what we see.
No.
It's what we don't see. The word of God is our proof. He's working. Just like he's worked it out before, he's working.
Don't start nothing. I'm gonna tell you.
Come on, we gotta go. He's working.
Don't start.
God is working.
Don't start.
Behind the scenes, he has a vision and a plan on the inside, and he's bringing it forth. Somebody say, "I'm a blockbuster hit." My life is a blockbuster hit, overflowing in finances. All the world will see. People will flock and say, who is this Jesus? Who is this King of glory that's manifesting in your life? Let me let this thing go.
Don't start, boy.
Hallelujah. If you're on here tonight and you're saying, I want to experience this, hallelujah, then it's made available here for you tonight. All you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, hallelujah, and you're saved, you're rescued and snatched out of your way of thinking, and his way of thinking flows, and God begins to work behind the scenes on your behalf. Immediately, somebody say immediately.
Amen.
He begins to become active in your situation, and the angels of God move out immediately to begin working on your behalf and creating those scenes that God has for your life.
Amen.
God's working behind the scenes. If that's you, just repeat after me. Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord. I receive Jesus. Hallelujah. Therefore, I'm going to begin to express who he is. God, I thank you. Hallelujah. That you rescued me tonight. I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that God raised Jesus from the dead. And I make a quality decision to accept that he's working on my behalf. He's active in my life right now in the name of Jesus. And I allow him and give him permission to create my story, to direct, hallelujah, my story, to manage and control my story. I'm becoming a blockbuster hit right now in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. I have everything that I need in abundance to the full and to the overflows, and God is working behind the scenes on my behalf, hallelujah. If that's you, welcome to the kingdom, hallelujah.
Welcome to the kingdom, amen. We thank God for you, and we would like
welcome to the kingdom.
Congratulate you and welcome you to your new life.
God,
in Christ
so awesome.
Jesus, you are a kingdom citizen. No matter what you've done,
no
your
matter
past
what
is over. All things have been made.
Scenes have been deleted.
And congregation, would you give God a hand
yes,
of
God,
praise
thank
as
you.
We receive those new believers into the family of
thank
God.
Thank you, Lord.
If you made that quality decision on tonight, we would like for you to go to our website at www.thekohci.org. And when you do, go to the button and connect with that says connect with us. And when you connect with us, you fill out the form that says I'm saved. And once you fill that form out and you send it back in to us, Pastor Laquita and I, we want to commune with you and counsel with you to share with you what it is you've obtained on tonight and give you knowledge and understanding and godly counsel to help you to maintain that which you've obtained.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Amen. We love you and we honor
yes,
God for
we love you.
You
all.
We appreciate
Hallelujah.
You so much. Amen. Amen. Give God praise.
Yes, God.
Amen. This was a wonderful
explosive
session.
Holy
amen.
Spirit.
And we could go on, but we want to be mindful of
yes.
your time, and we want to ensure that you have time to go and go back and relook at it. And,
yes.
and not only do that, just join with us and participate in spreading the gospel.
Yes.
You can do that by hitting the share button.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Like it and share it. Love it and share it. Amen.
Yeah.
Be a blessing to someone and,
yes.
and help us to continue to preach this gospel as we continue to transform the world. Amen. And manifest God's kingdom. Amen. We love you so much. We thank God
yes.
for you.
Yes.
You have anything else?
Yes. And we have to also make sure that we know that we're sowers. Amen.
Yes.
And so sowers sow into the kingdom of God. And so you also help us transform this world and manifest his kingdom when we sow into the message that you heard. Mix your faith with what you've just heard. And we're not going to spend all night on the sowers. Y'all know I don't want to leave y'all out. People say, Pastor, are we sowing tonight? You know, you're all sowers. Do what you know to do. Sow into the kingdom. Hallelujah. Sow and expect a harvest in the area which you have sown. When you sow your finances, expect a mighty harvest 1,000 times over that which has been sowed. Amen.
Amen.
Seeds produce after its own kind. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And so we know what to do. Amen. And so feel free at any time. I don't care if it's a Tuesday or Wednesday or Thursday. You're always welcome to sow into the kingdom. You see the Cash App. We have the PayPal, or you can mail it in. Sometimes any days of the week, things are coming in. We're operating in abundance and overflow here in the name of Jesus. God is continuing to sustain us financially. Hallelujah. We want to thank you all for that. Thank you for your continued support. People need to know. People need to hear that in the time of a pandemic and where that looks like that there's going to be an economic downfall, the people of God, I said the people of God, the sowers of God, God's chosen and elect, the spiritual of God, those who have an ear to hear and an eye to see and know God to be a miracle worker, hallelujah, they're still sowing.
Yeah.
They haven't stopped, hallelujah. There's still increases hitting their house. They're living under an open heaven. There's no lack. And people need to hear this. We've got to get to the place where we don't skate over that, hallelujah. And we don't put our finger up, hallelujah. But we experience the whole worship experience, hallelujah. Total worship experience. And included in that experience is to make sure that you understand the kingdom principle of sowing, hallelujah, and reaping, hallelujah. It's the kingdom principle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we thank you all for joining with us. We thank you all for your prayers. Hallelujah. As we laid Pastor WG's grandmother to rest, thank you for your cards. Thank you for all the flowers. Thank you for the phone calls. Thank you for your prayers. Hallelujah. Thank you for your diligence. Thank you for continuing to be mindful and to support us with the changes in the service. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We just thank you all for your prayers. We felt your prayers and your intercession, Father, in the name of Jesus, and we just thank the God our Father for you all, and we thank you because of that, what you poured into concerning that, God is unleashing and releasing that those things back into your life. Hallelujah. Unselfishly, you have continued to support us in the name of Jesus.
Amen. And I just want to say we're so grateful for that.
Hallelujah.
You know, we were on the road, and just because we were on the road, the mission didn't stop. The Lord made a way for us to deliver the message to you that he had in our hearts for you.
Yes.
And we thank God for you.
He was working behind the scenes.
your consistency and your support. And it didn't go unnoticed, and we really appreciate it. And we just ask that you continue to stick with us as we do the will of the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We thank love you so much, and we thank God for you. So let's pray. Father, we give you glory.
We give you glory, God.
We thank you for the gathering of the champions.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for, Lord, all of those, Lord, who have joined us on tonight.
Yes,
we thank you, Lord, that the word has been implanted into their souls.
Yes, yes.
And, Lord, transformation is already taking place.
Lord.
And we declare that their lives will never be the same.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, as we prepare to leave this place, but never from your presence, Father, we implore your angels to give them charge over us to keep us in all of our ways, protecting us from hurt, harm, and danger. Go before us, make the crooked, straight, and the rough smooth, and guide us, Father, throughout the rest of this week. I declare that the rest of this week will be magnificent and glorious in revealing the person of Jesus in our lives. Lord, we thank you and we praise you. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 See you on Sunday.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Continue to help us to transform the world and manifest the kingdom. Hallelujah.
Good night, everybody. Hey.
I'm a carrier of the king.